Hey, how's it going?
I'm good. How are you?
Tired. I don't know why, I'm just tired today.
Working hard, huh?
I think it's just partly getting old. Getting older, you know. I don't have the energy that I had 40 years ago.
It's just because you had your birthday.
Well, maybe that was some of it.
I find it's just harder to sort of bounce back from stuff.
I guess so. Okay, well, we're working on reviewing the 83. Mm-hmm. And we're working on the first 40 moves or so of this. And I think we should work on those, continue to work on those this weekend, and then next weekend go on to, I don't know, up to 60 or something. I'll have to look at the chart and see what it says. But let's work on those first 40 moves. So why don't I lead the first one? And I'll just lead the first one and then we'll go from there. Okay, Ram, why don't you do the next one?
Okay.
Watch the Daimai, especially on the left side here. So you're using the back of the forearm. The back of the forearm. Somebody's got hold of you, right? Somebody's got hold of you here. You turn your arm and you go like this. That causes your Daimai to turn to the left, right? Or rather, it's the other way around. Your Daimai turning to the left allows this to happen, right? And that pulls your right side over, right? So it's not just this, right? You're missing a lot of the stuff when you do it that way. So it's punch, turn back. Second thing, the punching sequence after the third time you do this, is 1, 2, 3, and then lead with back. That little punching sequence is different in every form. It's not the same as in the 24. It will be different in the 71, all right? So they deliberately do that, give you, in each form, give you a slightly different version of that. So that punching sequence in the 83 is very, very simple. It's actually simpler than in the 24. It's just right side, left side, right side, block down, and lean with back.
Malcolm, it's simpler except that we got used to the previous one.
That's right. That's what makes it hard. It's true. Okay, Susan.
All righty then.
Okay, in the second section of this form, we do walk obliquely, raise knee, and then wade forward. So three moves. And we repeat those. At the end of each section, there's a little stuff that's going on, and I want to go over that little stuff. So okay. Watch, just let me do this here. Watch. One, two, three. All right. So you can think of this as either defensive or offensive, or at least the first two slaps. But I think of them as offensive. You're slapping somebody upside the head. All right. So you've right. You come around under. Over, back to center, and then you sink a little bit more in the right quad, and then you slap this guy upside the head, and then you slap him upside the other side, and now you come right up under his chin. Now, when you do this coming up under the chin, watch my wrist. At the wrist, you cock the wrist. You have to have a knife hand. You're coming right up, not under his chin, but kind of right up in above the Adam's apple, right? Or you can think of it as into the Adam's apple, right? Boom. Right? So the hand doesn't just go forward, it goes up like a knife. One, two, three, right? And then you do it again. One, two, so it's under, over, back to center, chin up, and then both hands pull down, and one, two, three. All right. So those two are actually very similar. This first one, one, two, three. Right. The second one is one, two. Right. And then three. Does that make sense? Right? The first one again. One, two, three. All right? The second one. One, One, two, right? Three.
Okay.
Right. So the second one's a little more complex. Okay, good enough for today. We'll pick it up there tomorrow. And then next week, we're going to go on. So we've done up to move 40. Next week, we're going to go on from moves 41 to 57. 41 to 57. So you guys have all got the charts, right? So just practice 41 to 57 for next weekend.